Before you go live on YouTube, there are a few things you need to know and a few things that you need to do. So the first thing you need to understand are what are some of the requirements for you to be able to go live. If you don't do this, you won't be able to begin the live streaming process. So the first thing is that you need to be 16 years or older. You need to verify your channel, and you typically do this by linking a phone number to your account. So I'm going to show you in just a moment how to be able to do that. But if you don't verify your account, you won't even have the option to live stream. Then you need to make sure that you have no live stream restrictions in the last 90 days, meaning you haven't done anything wrong on your YouTube channel. Then you need to enable live streaming on your channel, and you must turn on live streaming feature in your YouTube settings. And this can take 24 hours to be able to activate. So in order for you to be able to activate that, you're going to come to your channel, and where it says create, you're going to select go live. When you select that button there, it's going to give you a button that's going to say enable live streaming. You simply click on that, and then after 24 hours, you'll get access and begin to see a studio just like this. So just kind of keep that in mind, that if you are going to be going live, you need to enable it first. So let's take a look at what else we have here. So the next thing that you're going to see is that it for the mobile specific requirements, we're not going live through mobile today. We're using OBS Studio. But just so you know, in order for you to go live directly from your mobile, you do need 50 subscribers. OK, and then, of course, when streaming, you need a stable internet. And we'll talk a little bit more about that as we start to dive into OBS Studio. So those are going to be the initial requirements that you kind of need to understand. Now let's go into more of the technical side of things on how to actually go live to YouTube using OBS Studio. So the first thing you want to do is you want to make sure you have OBS Studio installed. You install it for Windows, Mac, or Linux. Once you have that installed, what we want to do is you want to open it up. Now, the first thing that I encourage you to do is if you come up here to where it says tools, okay, there's going to be a thing that says auto configuration wizard. I encourage you to do this first just to get the base settings for your OBS to give you the best experience possible for YouTube, but I'm going to give you some modified settings that I think you should apply for OBS to get a better experience. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to optimize for streaming. Recording is secondary. You're going to go ahead and hit next. You're going to use your base canvas as 1920 by 1080. And then for the FPS, if you're going to be doing a lot of gaming, then you want to put this at 60. If you're just going to do you talking directly to the camera in your live streams, then you can go ahead and do 30. So I'm just going to go ahead and put 60. I'm going to hit next. And this is going to go ahead and ask you to go ahead and connect YouTube. I encourage you to do it this way because you get some extra features in OBS for live streaming to YouTube. So I encourage you to hit this, YouTube RTMPS. And then I encourage you to select connect account recommended. So you'll click on this here, and that's going to bring you over to your channel to go ahead and get connected. Once you've done that, what you're going to do next is give OBS authorization. And if you've done it correctly, you'll see the screen here where it says authorization completed successfully. You can now close this tab. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back here to OBS, and you see here that now my channel is connected. We can go ahead and leave it as prefer hardware encoder and estimate bitrate with bandwidth test. That's totally fine. We're going to hit next, and this is going to begin the process of testing. This is going to take into account what computer you're on, what settings you have, where we're streaming to, and it's going to give you the best settings possible for your machine. But we're going to go ahead and tweak that slightly here just because I know a little bit more about streaming to YouTube, and I know a little bit of settings that we can apply to get the most out of it. So you're going to see here, the program is now executing a set of tests to estimate the ideal settings. So once this is done, this is going to give us an ideal settings here. So it's going to say here our 10,000 bit rate and our resolution. Simply just hit apply settings. We're going to go ahead and tweak that here in just a moment. So you're going to see these things pop up. You're going to see your YouTube chat pop up. I will just drag it, place it here on the side, and then your live control panel here on the right. I would simply just exit out of that, and then we just need the chat. Something to keep in mind here. Your YouTube chat is only going to pop up once you go live, okay? When you're not live, this is what you'll see. It'll just be stationary. But you'll see here that because we connected YouTube directly to OBS without using any additional connection, we now have an option here to manage broadcasts. When we select that, this is going to allow us to set up everything we need for our live stream here in OBS without having to go to YouTube if we don't want to. But we'll get to that in a little moment here. Okay, so the first thing I want you to do is select settings. When we're here under settings, you're going to come to where it says stream. You're going to make sure that this is set up here for the right settings and everything that we have here. We can go ahead and leave this unchecked because we're going to definitely be way under this amount here. So what you're going to do is going to come to output. Right now we have it under simple. And what I want you to do is I want you to go ahead and select advanced because we want to make a few modifications to the settings that were defined. However, if you use the settings that were given, you're going to be A-okay. But I prefer to kind of optimize and tweak those settings just a little bit more. So when you come here to video encoder, this is super important. You want to select H.264 NVIDIA NVIC or X.264 based on what you have. Then we'll scroll down here and go to rate control, constant bit rate. Now, something I want you to understand here is when you come to this, to better understand what I'm looking for, is that in order to understand bit rate is determined based on your internet speed. And it determines how much bit rate you have available to be able to push to stream. Now, I'm going to tell you here, you may be interested in streaming in 4K, but I'm going to tell you right now that 1080p, 60 frames per second is more than enough. But if you want to get a crispier quality, then you can go 1440p, 60 or 30. Remember, if you're gaming, I encourage you to go 60. If you're just going to be talking to camera and talking to your community, then I would do 30. But we can look here that 1440p, 60 frames per second requires 24 MPS. And I'm going to explain to you what that means here in just a moment. We're going to focus in on 1080p, 60 frames per second, 12 MPS. So that means we need 12,000, okay? We need 12 upload to be able to make this possible, okay? 12 upload. So what I want you to do is to be able to check your internet speed. I want you to go to speedtest.net and all the tabs that I'm opening up, I'm going to put them in the description of this video so you can reference them and look at them at your own time. So you'll come to speedtest.net, you'll do a speed test, and it's going to give you your download and your upload. Now, remember, based off of this, we want to have at least 12, right? So in order for us to be able to put out 12 to YouTube, we want to make sure that we have at least double of this in our upload. So if this is 12, we want this number here to be at least 24. Now I have 941, so I can 100% support this, but you want to have this to be at least 30, okay? To be able to have some good breathing room in there, but 20 is totally fine because this is just a baseline. For 1080p, 60 frames per second, you can get away with 6 to 9, right? Meaning that you only need an 18. So if you have 20 to 30 upload, you're going to be able to stream with no problem over there. And the reason why I say you want to have double is because you may be gaming on there. There may be other devices in your household. And the last thing you want is for this to lag. So again, this is the things you want to understand because you want to be able to troubleshoot if you have any kind of issues. So once we've identified what our upload speed is and that we can support that in streaming, we now want to come to OBS and get that set up here. So you see that the bit rate is at 6,000, right? So all we want to do is we want to switch this here to 12,000, okay? And again, if you don't have, let's say 24 upload, you can go ahead and bring this down to 9 or leave it at 6 if you only have a 12 upload. Once we've done that, we now want to come here to keyframe intervals, leave it at 2, preset. Okay, this is super important. This is all based on your computer. Okay, so this is where I mean that you need to understand a little bit of troubleshooting because these are some of the things that you would modify if you start to experience some delay or choppiness in your live stream. So what you want to do is you can have it at medium. And again, this is coming from the test based on the computer that you have. But if you start to experience some choppiness or lag, you want to lower this here closer to P3 or P2. Again, the more quality and the more effort you want your computer to do and the more you want out of it, the higher you go, okay? The faster and smoother you want your stream to be, if it can't support it, the lower you go. But 4 is a good safe spot to give you a balance of both, okay? Then tuning, we want to have this at high quality, okay? Or you can have it at ultra low latency, which is going to be based allowing you to have the fastest response time when it comes to communicating with your chat. So I'm just going to have it at high quality. Multi-pass mode, 2 passes. profile high, look ahead, you want to uncheck this. And then in adaptive quantization, you want to have this checked. And then brief frames, you want to have it at 2. Now, you want to really quick here, come here to where it says advanced. And there's a few things that we want to make sure that we do here. So you want to come to where it says network, and you want to select dynamically change bitrate to manage congestion. So what this means is that if you have it set to a certain amount, right? We just set it to 12,000, which is 12 upload. If for some reason somebody gets on your internet, somebody streaming on another part of your household, and you don't have enough, OBS is going to automatically adjust for that, allowing you to maintain a smooth stream. So I encourage you to go ahead and have that checked there. Then we're going to come here to video, and you want to make sure this is at 1920 by 1080, 1920 by 1080, and the FPS is at 60. Okay. This is going to be super important here for you to be able to have. We'll simply press apply, press OK, and now our OBS is pretty much ready to go live over to YouTube. But there's a few things that we need to do on the YouTube end just to get things a little bit prepped here for you. So what you want to do is you want to come back to YouTube. And again, once you've gone ahead and allowed the 24 hours to pass, if you didn't have this enabled, you'll see this screen here. So what we want to do is you want to come here to where it says edit. And there's a few things that we want to go ahead and set up. The first thing is that we can go ahead and predefine a description for our live streams, meaning that you can set this up one time and not have to do it over and over again. Okay. Then when you scroll down, this is super important, visibility. If this is on private, no one's going to see your live stream. Okay. So this is great if you just want to do a private live stream and you want to be able to just see it for yourself. Okay. Unlisted means that people won't be able to see your live stream unless you share a link with them. Okay, so unlisted is great to be able to test and send it to friends and family to be able to see if the audio sounds good, if you look good, if the quality is good. It allows you to be able to test. Okay, and then public is when you want everyone to be able to see that live stream, meaning that YouTube is going to present it to people, it's going to pop up on YouTube, and people are going to be able to see it. And then after your stream is over, people will continue to be able to see this live stream as well. So I'm going to leave this as unlisted now because I'm going to show you what it looks like when you actually go live. Then when you scroll down here, you're going to see category. If you're gaming, put gaming, then put the gaming title. Then you want to put your thumbnail, which is super important. Like the biggest thing on YouTube, if you want to get people to be able to click on your stream and get people watching, is to have a good thumbnail and to have a good title. I've done videos on my channel showing you how to create a thumbnail for your videos that gets people to want to be able to click. I'll link it under this description. But we'll have here a few additional options. These are some of the most important things you want to make sure you toggle. You want to make sure this video is not set and made for kids, okay? So if your content is not made for kids, and what I mean by that, by not made for kids, is not that it's kid-friendly, okay? But if your content is specifically for kids, like for kids, you need to make sure that you say, yes, it's for kids, because it's going to remove certain features that you get access to that kids wouldn't be privy to use, okay? So if you want to learn more about that, just simply say what content is made for kids, and you'll be able to see what that looks like. Paid promotions, you can leave that on. Alter content, you want to have that at no or yes based on the questions that are here. And then you can simply leave this checked here where it says allow automatic chapters, stuff like that. You can add predefined tags here, and then everything else will remain the same. Okay, so once you've done that, we can go ahead and back out of that. Okay, now what I want to show you is that in OBS Studio, if you click manage broadcast, you're going to see a few of those additional, the same settings that we went ahead and just adjusted. But if you see here, you have create a new broadcast or select an existing broadcast. So what I can do is that I can come here and select this existing one and that I already went ahead and created and be able to go ahead and start and stop that stream. But if you want to create a new one, you'll simply hit your title. You can select, remember these settings, put your description here. Decide what you want to do, unlisted, your category. You can go ahead and say, put a no, not made for kids. Add your thumbnail, select your latency, which I typically put low. And then you can decide if you want to enable DVR, which is a meaning that people can come back and watch it afterwards, right? So once you've filled out all these things here, you can now do two things. You can create the broadcast, okay? Or you can schedule it for later. And if you schedule it for later, you can come in here and select the date and the time for which you want to schedule that. And then all you need to do is simply go live in OBS for at that scheduled time. But let's go ahead and go live now, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove that schedule. So let's say I'm ready to go live. I can simply go ahead and hit create broadcast and start streaming. Or I can simply just select start streaming here. Okay. Now I don't have any windows or anything inputted in there. I'll leave that for another video where I show you how to add your camera, add overlays and stuff like that. And I'll show you here in just a moment where that video is. But now let's go ahead and say we want to go ahead and start streaming. It's going to say you need to set up a broadcast before you begin streaming. So that's fine. Manage the broadcast. We have this all set up here. I'm going to have this as unlisted. I'm going to select no here. And you see here that if you don't select this, you don't get the option here at the bottom. So now we can select create broadcast and start streaming. It's going to now say creating a live stream. And you'll see here now our chat is now open for us to be able to see what people are saying. So again, you don't have to go to YouTube to be able to see your chat. You can see it directly inside of OBS Studio. Now, again, now you can see here that we have green bars. That's good. We can see that our CPU usage is 1.1. You want to make sure that that remains at least under 30 whenever you're doing anything on OBS, whether it's gaming, whether it's talking, when you have your overlays, because that means that you have breathing room to have a smooth stream. So now, if you want to be able to see the stream on YouTube, okay, what you need to do is you need to come to your channel. And then all you want to do is under your profile icon, you'll click YouTube Studio. You'll come to content. You'll see live. And now we see the broadcast right here. Okay, so if we click on this, we can see all the things that we went ahead and set up. But if you want to see the data on it, you want to click here, view in control room. This is now going to bring you over to the stream that you see. You see, we have the end stream button here. You see that we're live. We can see that it's excellent condition, that we have great settings that are being able to be utilized. We can monitor the chat and you can see how many people are tuning in, how many people are not tuning in. Now, when you want to end your stream, okay, when you're done, you can come here to OBS and hit stop streaming and hit yes, okay? When you hit stop streaming there, you're going to see here that directly on YouTube, it's going to remain here live. So what you want to make sure is you select end stream at the top and hit end to make sure that is done. And then you'll see some metrics and data for your YouTube stream. Now, going back to OBS, you now have all the settings to be able to have a smooth stream going out to YouTube. Okay, but if you want to learn how to be able to add your camera, add your gameplay, add overlays, add alerts, things that spice up your live stream and give it a more professional look, I encourage you to watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on setting up all of that inside of OBS Studio. I'll see you in that video right there.